Yes.
How did you do that?
It was great. It's just a continuation of part one. And I enjoy doing them, instrumentals. That's what I do. That's what I'm into, more than anything. And I felt this, it was a good time to do it again, to put another one out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How do you feel about the music scene now? Have you been having a long time now? How do you feel about music at this time?
I feel cool about it. I don't feel bad about anything. I feel like hip hop is as big as ever, and I feel that there's so many spectrums of it that you can pick and choose your weapon. And, I have a fan base of the kind of music I do. And, I just kind of listen to everything that's out there and just apply myself to it. You know what I'm saying? You got to roll with the punches.
That's it, yeah. It's one big dance, really, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely.
Stick and move and all that stuff.
Yeah.
How was it with working with Public Enemy to do...
It was great, man. I mean, work doing those remixes for them, Night Train and Shut Them Down was like the ultimate feeling for me, and the way people perceived it, it just had me floating on cloud nine, And, just want to represent hip hop to the fullest, like I always do.
Classic tracks.
Thank you. Big respect to Public Enemy, Chuck D, big homie. And yeah.
He's a great man, Chuck. He's done a great deal.
Definitely.
For hip-hop.
Big respect for Chuck D.
He gave it sophistication.
Mm-hmm.
He gave it sophistication.
Yes, he did. And he spoke his mind, always. And that's something that people like me are attracted to. I just kind of want to make music to match who he was.
That's why it married well, probably.
Yeah.
What are you working on now?
Now I'm working on Soul Survivor 3.
Yeah.
And just, on the road, here and there, in the studio with people.
Keeping busy. Do you have anything specific in mind for this new album?
It's just a bunch of beats, nothing really scientific I did. I just, took beats I had, put them together and mixed them in the studio.
Yeah, and you feel, this music's the thing you feel anyway, so it's not just a product, it's not just something okay, I'll just pick this thing up. You've got to really be into that.
Yeah, and I've been into music since I was 3 years old. I was born into it, so it's in our blood, man, and for my family, my pop being a DJ, my cousin Heavy D, who's also into music, and our whole family.
And he's passed on now.
Yeah, rest in peace. Rest in peace. He put me in the game. Yeah. And a lot of people gave me a shot that I'm grateful to. Molly Mall. Giving me a chance to be a DJ on the radio.
Yeah. Marley Marl's great. He did all the Notorious B.I.G. things as you did as well.
Yeah.
Some great beats.
Definitely.
It's a shame in a way that, there is a credit given, but somehow the new seems to just be so predominant.
It is what it is, man.
Yeah.
We have a different audience of kids out here. Kids today are very, very different, growing much faster than usual than we did when we were kids. And their patience level is like now, I'm not a rush type person, but you know, I'll get something done when it needs to be done. But you know, I feel I like my pace of how I work. You know what I'm saying?
Similar to Jay Rude again, he said to me that, you know, the road is not for the swift.
Yeah.
It's for the one that has the patience.
Exactly. You know, that's an important thing in anything you do, patience. And you know, with music, I always want to make something great, so I have that kind of patience. And there's other spectrums of patience I need to work on. You know, but like everyone else, I'm human. You know, nobody's perfect, but you know what I mean?
Just learning to live in the higher self rather than the lower self.
Yeah.
As we would say, is more.
Yeah. Basically.